Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. Guess what one of the most frequent asked questions is? And I'm going to have to update the top 10 list. If you don't know what I'm talking about, it's for hot dog vending, hot dog stands, anything to do with street food vending. The top questions, which apply broadly across many different types of street food vending, you can go to learnhotdogs.com/10. The number 10, or spell it out, doesn't matter. It's going to take you there. One of the new questions that I get asked most is how does a hot dog vendor, how does a hot dog stand cook their hot dogs? And it's a boil, steam, or grill. That's your options. Boil, steam, or grill. Well, which one's best? Well, some of these come down to the type of dog it is. Does it have a natural casing? Is it a synthetic casing? Does it even have a casing? All of those matter. Most vendors boil, okay? New York is famous for having dirty water dogs, but New York is not the foremost place for hot dogs anymore. Guess what state is? North Carolina. So it is, Florida's number two, New York's number three. So that's where your hot dog carts are. So what are those vendors using? I have insight because I work with tens of thousands of vendors worldwide, but in the States, I work with thousands of vendors, many of which are in our Vendors United group. It's called vendorsunited.com. Okay. If you want to check it out, it's free. Check it out. Okay. And that will help you. It helps me know what people are doing, changes in the industry, that type of stuff. But that common question, a recurring question, is which is the best way to cook the dogs? Everybody likes a grilled dog, right? But grilled dogs take longer, and it's hard to take a grilled dog and save it, okay? Because depending on the type of dog you use, it will look like a shriveled up wiener that's been sitting outside in the sunshine for 14 years if you grill it and hold it. But some of them hold their shape and hold all the char and everything and look great. So you have to test those. But then you also have to do a taste test, because you may find a good hot dog that holds up well after being grilled inside of a dry heat steamer or even a just dry heat that holds up well, but nobody likes it, right? So you have to go with what your demographic, the people around you, use. So I went directly to boiled dogs. It was the most common. Boiled dogs, they call them dirty water dogs. So you'll boil them for 6-7 minutes from frozen, and then you turn off the heat or put it on very, very, very low and let it sit in that water. Now, there's some negatives to that. Some people go, well, the danged old hot dogs lose their flavor in the water. So I said, you know what? I'm going to spice my water up. So I put a beef bouillon cube in there, maybe some garlic cloves. A lot of people have gone crazy with this and put all kinds of stuff in it, okay? And that helps the water become super saturated, and then the water doesn't sap out all the flavor from the hot dogs. So you can test this out in your kitchen. You don't need to turn on the hot dog cart to know what's going to work for you. You can test it out in your kitchen, invite some friends and family over, and cut up the hot dogs. I've got a video doing this, but cut up the hot dogs, put different color toothpicks in different dogs, and let everybody try a bite and see what they like best. Now, dirty water dogs are fantastic, plus they have a longevity, so they last. I mean, you could have a slowdown for an hour and a half, and those dogs sitting in the water still just like you had just cooked them 2 seconds ago. Where grilled dogs are a little harder to keep, and you have to determine what type of dogs to buy to be able to do that and hold them where they don't look like a shriveled up raisin when you go to give them out and have a weird, toughy texture. So you have to try that. Then there's another one. A lot of manufacturers of hot dogs will say, hey, our dogs are best steamed. You can do them how you want, but they're best steamed. Well, sometimes that is the case. And if the manufacturer suggests that, then that's what I suggest you do, which works out well because it holds the flavor, heats quick. If you've watched my rapid steam video, you'll see that you can rapid steam hot dogs, and in seconds you have a steaming, piping hot hot dog. And so you can steam the buns, you can steam the hot dogs, and you can just swap them out. So you take two out, put two in. Take two out, put two in. And you can do that all day long, and it maintains it. Then you don't have a lot of holding dogs. Dogs that are sitting in a grill or sitting in a dry pan or a steam pan just kind of turning into crap. And so it depends. So the bottom line is, depends on the type of dog, okay? And it's going to require you to do some taste testing, okay? Because you don't, it doesn't matter if you go, I've got to do charred dogs, everybody likes charred dogs, and you find out charred dogs don't hold well. And you, when I say hold well, charred dogs are something you can cook on the grill, hand to somebody. Well, that's not a quick process when you got a line of 50 people. So you need to be able to store some, right? Put some, grill them, put them in a steamer. Michael Wood did this all the time. He figured out what dog worked for him best to hold after being grilled and not look crappy. We've got videos on that too. So anyway, I hope that helps. I hope that helps make some sense. So always do a taste test. Figure out the way you want to cook it, then do taste tests on multiple dogs. Figure out what you like. And if you want the dogs that work best steamed, or the dogs that work best boiled, or the dogs that work best grilled, you can go to learnhotdogs.com. You can go to vendorsunited.com, and we've broken it down. And plus there's vendors doing it. So anyway, I love you. Talk to you later. Bye.